I was on a bus and I saw this girl and she was sad, so I kind of knew the story and started. She was open-minded, strong, thrilled, and confident. She was poor, no money, never asked for a single cent. All she ever wanted was for someone to come on by, sweep her off her feet. Not just a dude from the block who's looking to beat. She just wanted to be treated like a human being, not a possession, because that's what all the guys she was seeing saw her as. They thought they owned her, told her what to do, where to go, how to dress. Come home every night and expect some sex. But baby, I don't love you yet, is what she would say. They didn't care, tied her down and raped her anyway. Tears streaming down her face, muffled screams filled the place, the apartment where she lived at, being violated in her own home. Now you see why she always felt so alone, praying to God every night to give her a gift, for all the hard work that she's shown. Maybe a good paying job, help her work on a college degree, give her the opportunity to one day just break free from all the pain and hurt she lived with every day. Give her someone who would take it away. So one day she met a nice guy, a man she could give her all to. Made promises to her that he'd stay true. Never treat her like her exes. Drive her out aimlessly at night, chilling in the Lexus. He bought her nice things, necklaces, rings. Every Friday night, surprise candle at dinner. She thought she had a winner. Body sweating, moving together in sync. The first one she ever been truly intimate with was him. She was more caught up than she had ever been. 2 year anniversary comes. She lived for making him happy. She gave him all she had. Little did she know things would soon turn bad. Coming home at 2 a.m., late night at the office. Smelling of perfume, try to get him off himself, but she noticed. She wasn't an idiot, though. She was too afraid to confront him about it. She didn't believe her. He didn't need her. Fuck with his secretary and coming home to his faithful girl, the one who saw him as a world. The thought of him leaving was chilling, even though she bore that feeling of deceiving lies. Looked into his eyes and saw infidelity. She put up with the police. At night, she'd be up in the police creeping. He thought he was slick, thinking with the head of his dick instead of his heart, his soul. Both of which told her she was the one. He continued to ignore the messages when he wanted more power. And that, looking for love in all the wrong places, and every pretty face he saw, he pulled him over, cheating on his lady without an ounce of regret or shame. Gave them all the same. So one day she decided she had enough. She was too good for him, too strong, too tough. Why should she put up with the shit he was giving her? So she took out that 8-cylinder loaded and cocked it. The inconspicuous just slipped it in her pocket. Wait till he walks in the door. 5 minutes later, you're a betrayer. You said you'd give me the world and send your out piece of sex and I'll tend to the girls. You think I know? How stupid do you take me for? I can't do this anymore. Baby, I love you. She was crying, deciding whether to shoot or give him mercy. Because if she didn't, the pain would just get worse, see? Loved? He asked, looking at her with question. Using her discretion, she pointed the gun at him, pulled the trigger, shaking fingers. The pain would no longer linger in her broken heart, which from that day slowly started to repair itself with no help from anyone.